Tomorrow counted for me because 17 years ago I was diagnosed with prostate cancer. And I faced that dilemma which faces all men who have that diagnosis. What are you going to do? You're going to have treatment, or are you going to watch and wait and do nothing? It's unique, I think, in most health problems to have that choice available to you. And it's not a comfortable choice, because what are you going to do? I was a self-employed actor, writer. It meant I'd be off work for quite a considerable amount of time. And that alternative about watching and waiting and doing nothing, well, I paced the floor debating with myself, what should I do? As far as my wife was concerned, that's fine. The cancer was like a bad tooth, pull it out, get rid of it. But for me, it wasn't an easy decision. Now, when my surgeon asked me how I was coping with that, and I told him about this self-debate that I was having, he said, look, you're a writer. Would you compile it, your experience, into book form, provided you survive, of course, because there's nothing in the literature at that time, 17 years ago, from the patient's point of view. He said, I've done hundreds of these operations. I don't know how a patient feels. So I continued taking my little notes. And when the surgery was over and I did survive, I looked back to edit those notes. And I came across these fears that I had at 4 o'clock in the morning pacing the floor. And I thought, oh, I'll take that out, you know. That I thought, no, that's my story. That was my journey. So when the book came out, of course, that's what resonated with so many men. They weren't the only ones facing that terrible decision. And their partners or their wives bought the book too, because they wanted to know what their man was going through. Now, as I repeat, this was 17 years ago, and the men's health nights, which now, thank God, are all over the place, barely existed. And I was invited to speak at one of the first of them. And the organizers said, oh, we might be lucky to get 200 fellas tonight, but they got 500. And I realized that things were changing. A quiet revolution was beginning. Men were wanting information about their health. They were wanting to ask questions about their health. So as a playwright, I decided, all right, I'll take my story and I'll adapt it into a stage play. Now, I found it most important when I was writing the play to put as much humor in it as I could. And as it was my story, I had the right to make jokes about it, because a lot of people say, well, what's funny about cancer? But if you can find aspects of your experience which are humorous, that helps, for example, in my case, an audience watching my play relax. And I found that they're laughing at some of the issues which would otherwise be considered most confronting and perhaps uncomfortable. So this was a way I found to get the information about prostate cancer out to men in general. The most important message I wanted to get out to them was I had no symptoms. I was detected because I went to my doctor to check my blood pressure, and he said, well, you're over 50. Have you had a PSA blood test? I said, what's that? He told me what it was, and he said, all right, let's give you a digital examination. So after that, I said, gee, doc, to think some blokes do that for pleasure. And that, of course, is one of the jokes that I put in my play. Because all the things that happened to me, I found some element of comedy in it, which, of course, helped me get through the experience. Now, the important message that I have to get over to men is face the problem, over 50, go and have an examination. If you're diagnosed with prostate cancer, then you have a very important decision to make, which only you can make. You make it in terms of what's good for you and for your family. As I said, in my case, my wife totally supported my decision. Now, 17 years later, I'm still here. Something worked. And part of my life's work is actually to present that play and to get that message out to the widest public possible. Tomorrow counts for me because obviously it gave me the opportunity not only to continue with life, but as it turned out, it gave me an opportunity to tell my story to help other men facing the same problem. to face it with positivity and, if possible, a bit of a smile and a bit of a laugh.